and also with you.
Struggled together within her, and she said, "If it is to be this way, why do I live?" So she went to a
glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus went out and sat beside the sea. Such great crowds gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat there, while the whole crowd stood on the beach. And he told them many things in parables, saying, "Listen, the sower went out to sow. And as he sowed, some seeds fell on the path, and the birds came and ate them up. Other seeds fell on rocky ground, where they did not have much soil. And they sprang up quickly, since they had no depth of soil. But when the sun rose, they were scorched. And since they had no roots, they withered away. Other seeds fell on thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked them. Other seeds fell on good soil, and brought forth grain, some a hundredfold, some 60, some 30. Let anyone with ears listen. Hear then the parable of the sower. When anyone hears the word of the kingdom and does not understand it, the evil one comes and snatches away what is sown in the heart. This is what was sown on the path. As for what was sown on rocky ground, this is the one who hears the word and immediately receives it with joy. Yet such a person has no root, but endures only for a while. And when trouble or persecution arises on account of the word, that person immediately falls away. As for what was sown among thorns, this is the one who hears the word, but the cares of the world and the lure of wealth choke the word, and it yields nothing. But as for what was sown on good soil, this is the one who hears the word and understands it, who indeed bears fruit and yields, in one case 100-fold, in another 60, in another 30. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Starting to kind of argue with Jesus because he, especially
abundant harvest. We may not see it right now. But the God who provides abundantly and provides for all of us, no matter what the situation, will provide for us still. And we have a choice about whether or not we get anxious about what looks like waste, or are we going to set our eyes on the kingdom, the abundant harvest? How can we hold the vision that God has always provided abundantly, still going to provide abundantly? And yes, that will be with the help of you and me. The things we do to care for our neighbors right now, our neighbors in need. And the harvest is coming that is abundant. God's promised it. It will come. Holding on to that vision is kind of hard right now. But that is the vision we are to spread of God's kingdom. That there will be a harvest, it will be abundant, because God is the Lord of both the waste, or what looks like waste to us, and the harvest. Amen.
Amen.
Son of God,
God from God,
light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried.
On the third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures.
He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father.
He will come again in glory
to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit,
the Lord of the eternal life,
who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Father, we pray for your holy Catholic church.
That we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the church may truly and humbly serve you.
That they may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons, especially for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, for Michael, our presiding bishop, for Eugene, our bishop, for Robert, our assisting bishop, for our rector, Elizabeth, for the wardens, vestry staff, and all members and friends of St. John's Church.
That they may be
ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world, especially for Donald, our president, for Larry, our governor, Jack, Brandon, and John, who lead our city and counties, that they may be led to wise decisions and right actions for the welfare and peace of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do with your will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
Let light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
We also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others.
ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us.
May we live in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness by the power of the Holy Spirit. Keep you in eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
I'm a priest here in the Diocese of Maryland, and I
Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above, ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
It
is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right to the good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on the first day of the week overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with the angels and archangels, with all the company of heaven, who forever sing to you.
Holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
Celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit, to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all of your saints into the joys of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask for your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us keep the feast. Hallelujah.
Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
And you have fed us with spiritual food
in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you. Lead us in singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Be to God.